Oh, hi. Mark Pearson, Executive and Artistic Director of the College Light Opera Company. Welcome to CLOCTAILS, a weekly broadcast of interviews and music by CLOC alums. This week I got to catch up with three-time CLOC alum Kyle Yampiro. But before we get to Kyle, this wouldn't be CLOCTAILS without a cocktail. This week we're featuring the Falmouth Firecracker, a drink we created last year when the 4th of July fell on one of our two show days. The Falmouth Firecracker is the perfect cocktail to enjoy during your 4th of July celebrations. And here's how it's made. You can make this drink as a punch, or in a pitcher, or just in a wine glass. I like a big wine glass. You'll need Prosecco, elderflower liqueur, raspberry rose seltzer, and frozen raspberries and blueberries for garnish. The frozen berries will keep your drink cool. Add a jigger of elderflower liqueur, a generous pour of Prosecco, and top it off with raspberry rose seltzer. And there you have your Falmouth Firecracker. Cheers!
Don't be alarmed, madam. Absolutely no cause for alarm. Allow me to present myself. Colonel Gustav Brock. I have the honor to be the governor for the municipal penitentiary for the reception of Class B delinquents and malefactors.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
So, Kyle, it's great to see you. So what have you been doing since you left CLOC?
Since I left CLOC, million years ago, and yet 3 minutes in CLOC time. I finished my doctorate at James Madison University. I did some teaching with fellow CLOC alum Jacob Allen at the University of Memphis. And I have been pursuing performing full time. I've had some summers in Colorado, New Hampshire, and four summers at the Ohio Light Opera. And in the last few years, I moved back home to commute to New York City and look into being an actor for hire. So musical theater, opera, you pay me, I'm there.
Albums for lovers with hot, sexy covers. It's love, yes, it's love, fills the tale.
I did. I was on the American Spiritual Ensemble tour. The last night of our tour was the night that the NBA canceled its season, and then we came home the day that Broadway shut down. I was actually set to go to a J2 Spotlight Music Theater Company show, the opening, and it went through all the different phases of, no, don't worry, we're not canceled, to we're definitely canceled. The world is canceled. Everything's on fire. So I had a few gigs that were canceled, unfortunately, for the summer. I'm hopeful for what comes next, when we move forward. But for now, I am exactly where I was on that day when I came back, and that is at home on Long Island.
It's always best to go to prison in a philosophic state of mind. So few people seem to manage it. Sleep with me, break with me, sing.
Oh no, I'm on duty.
I've been working a part-time job over the phone this entire time. I've been taking classes with a lovely online studio in New York City. They have moved to online classes for acting and theater, and it's been fantastic. Otherwise, just sort of tinkering around with what does a performer do when unable to do live performing. So I am very interested in checking out what a voiceover career looks like. I am working on a project with another CLOC alum who's working with you this season, Sophie Thompson, on an early music theater project where we're going to revive some songs from old shows. Starting with Kern's Nobody Home.
Great. So
really, really cool stuff. And we're going to hopefully drop some of that stuff in the next, within the next month. And
I was going to say, make sure you let us know, because totally. A lot of our viewers will want to tune in.
Absolutely. Really excited about it. So yes, it's all in the putting it together phases now, with some OLO alumni and Eastman folks. It's going to be a lot of fun.
Don't speak. I need your attention. I'm not going to say this twice. I'm your landlord. And this piece of paper says you got to treat me nice. Lady, I'm the one with the rule book. Who say what you can to my cat? Because you're living on an Elliot Garfield. An Elliot Garfield. Grandpa, love him. Elliot Garfield and Elliot.
Let's talk a little bit about your time at CLOC. What were some of your favorite roles when you were here? Or remind us how many summers you worked.
So I was in the vocal company 2010, 2011, and 2013. Some of the best times and some of the most meaningful roles to me. To name a few, Tony in The Most Happy Fella. Julian Marsh in 42nd Street. Frank in Fledermausse. Whew. I mean, the list goes on.
And are there any particular memories that stick out in your head? Favorite moments or funny stories?
What can I say in an interview that goes public to people?
Something that I actually thought about the other day was the chair incident.
Oh my gosh, I still have that chair.
You do?
I do. Oh man, I still have that chair back. So so we rehearsed this thing, and the Act 3 melodrama starts with Frank dancing with the chair as part of coming back from the party. And every time we did it, it was pretty consistent. I would dance with the chair, and at a certain point in the music, something would startle me and I would drop the chair. Opening night, it was a little different because I heard some sound when the chair dropped that was like, that's not a good, it felt like normal sound. And I could tell right away when I went to go sit on it, this ain't the same chair anymore. Something is broken about it. And so I had basically clocked when entrances and exits happened. And right away in the first scene, in the back of my head, I'm thinking, this is going to be a problem. At least two more people stand on this chair as part of the blocking. And it's not weight bearing right now. There's no way. How do I telegraph to people? Don't do it. It looks like a chair. It's not a chair. And it occurred to me that there was a moment that I could send Frosh off for one of his natural entrances and exits with it before there's too much collateral damage. And I said, at the end of a line that was sending him off, I said, and fix this chair. And if the audience hadn't caught on at that point, they did when he came back on with the stage management stool, because we were fresh out of chairs. And he said, I don't have a chair, but I have this stool. Yeah. And that was just another moment for applause. And that night we went on with Eisenstein standing on a stool. We were this close to an Adele that didn't make it, because unfortunately Amber took one try at the chair and was like, mm-mm. And so that night was a meet and greet. And everybody was laughing, but the tech folks came back to me and said, you deserve this. They gave me the chair back. That's all. That's the only thing that I took.
Let's talk about your process as an artist. So when you are approaching a role or a show, how do you prepare for that? What's your process like, and how do you get from the beginning to your end product?
So that is one of the coolest things about my time at CLOC, was that my process almost completely changed just naturally. When you prepare 9 shows in a summer, and at least 7 of them are literal show in a week style. It's just your brain learns to prioritize what is and is not important. And so the speed at which I can learn English material is just freakish in some ways, because of it's cross-training for your brain. And so now for me, it wasn't just 9 shows, it was 27. So I find that it's not as applicable for pieces in a foreign language. There's something from that direct, like, this is my native tongue to this is my brain and getting from A to B. But I found that some simple repetition sticks a lot quicker than it used to. So like drilling in between rehearsals was a huge help. But it's when you have to learn something so quickly, you then do. And so it impacted my process afterwards.
Because we will now hear testimony from Brother Nicely Nicely Johnson. Brother Nicely Nicely Johnson.
Get out, you fat water buffalo. Well, it happened kind of funny. Like a dream. That's it, a dream.
Then tell us in your own words.
I dreamed last night I was on a boat
to heaven,
and by some chance I had brought my dice along, and there I stood, and I hollered, someone paid me, but the passengers, they knew right from wrong. For the people said, sit down, you're rocking the boat. People said, sit down. Now, by remember, I don't know how my body did any of the things that it did when I was there. Besides the drinking, then to like get up the next day and do a lot of rehearsal, sometimes 2 shows. What always amazed me was the week or so after CLOC, when you would come back to the real world, and your body is like working at this superhuman pace. And it takes about a week to realize the rest of the world doesn't work at this pace, and it's okay to slow down. And then you slow down to the level at which everybody else is at. But it's just kind of,
incredible what all we're able to do. I mean, it was always, always work hard, play hard. And right. They are some of the best memories I don't have.
Did you have a favorite beverage while you were at CLOC?
Yes. There were two mainstays for me that sort of spoke to the college atmosphere that was there. So I had this giant Walmart tumbler for like $1, and that was my go-to. And I made two drinks when there was occasion to, and that was a watermelon watermelon Sprite. So it was a watermelon vodka mixed with Sprite. So it was like a watermelon Jolly Rancher. Yeah. Uh-huh.
And with or without ice.
With or without ice, yes. The answer is yeah. Could we get into the kitchen that night? That was the question. And then it was like half passion fruit rum and half Arizona iced tea. It's actually delightful. But it is a headache in the morning, I'll tell you that.
Call me fool. That's all right with me. Here's my rule. Never disagree. Where's my pride? Swallowed long ago. Deep inside, where it doesn't show. Bowing, scraping, nodding, beaming. Always humble, not an ounce of self-respect. Yes, sir, you're so right, sir. Black is white, sir. Excuse me while I genuflect. How do I remain so calm and cheerful? How do I maintain my peace of mind? Let me just explain my rationale. It's all in your perspective. Listen to an old Italian's philosophy. I am only one of several in this rather small cabaret space, which is only one of several in the city. Which is one of many cities in this country, which is only one of many countries, which is on this continent, which is only one of seven on this not-so-special planet, which is one of many in our solar system, which is only one of many solar systems in this vast and inconceivable affair that is the universe. So, in this infinite, incomprehensible scheme, if a dot called manager should scream at a speck called Kyle, what on earth does it matter? So call me fool, that's all right with me. Here's my rule, never disagree. Where's my pride, swallowed long ago? Deep inside, where it doesn't show. Just maintain a true perspective, and it's easy to avoid a clash of wills. Just maintain a true perspective, and be sure you're well supplied with stomach pills. Let me just explain it. I'm a coward, with a wife and children to support. Actually, my creed is short and simple. Five essential words all. Do not lose your job.
So you were a CLOC for 3 years. Are you still in contact with any of your fellow CLOCers from those years?
I am, actually. Some of my best friends in the world, I would say. So in addition to having some colleagues from my CLOC years at the Ohio Light Opera, from my first 2 years, my third year are some of my best friends. I married Bruce and Shelley. They asked me to literally tie that knot, and I thought, me? Am I allowed to do that? And but apparently the state of Vermont does allow that kind of thing. It was just so cool because I got to see them get together in 2013. And kind of play a little wingman. And then I seal the deal.
I'm sure you must have, trying to remember, you must have played a priest or a minister at some point in something.
For at least like 3 minutes. The first thing that comes to mind is On the 20th Century in 2011.
Yes.
Branded again. Right. Screwed again.
The day's right.
So what's next for you, or do you know?
I'm probably gonna have a coffee, and I'm probably gonna go. I've got some glasses, but as far as anything in the distant future, I really don't. I would love to know that, but the world is changing every day, and I am hopeful to when theater is safe to do again. I am hopeful to be able to be as open and flexible to a return to it. In this time, it's not, you know, if it were a couple of months, it would be one thing to just sort of say, we'll weather the storm. But with an extended absence, I'm looking into what ways a theater artist's skills will translate into the workforce.
One more question that I'm going to ask you, especially since you had 3 summers here. If you could give one piece of advice to your clock-aged self, what would it be?
It would probably be about the peppermint schnapps and chocolate syrup. If you are planning to rehearse a drunk scene and think it a good idea to get drunk on similar alcohol that you drink in the show, rehearse very, very early on in the process, because the probability of actually rehearsing decreases exponentially as time goes on. There's my experience-based nugget of wisdom.
Well, Kyle, it's been lovely talking to you. Thanks so much for joining us.
Absolutely. Thanks for having me.
J'ai perdu mes lunettes dans la mer!
This broadcast was part of our larger programming, Digital CLOC. Digital CLOC was made possible by a generous gift from Phil and Liz Gross. If you'd like to learn more about our programming or how you can become a supporter, please visit us at collegelightoperacompany.com. And please join us next week for another installment of CLOCTAILS. See you there.